So today I have someone really, really energetic and she's a very vibrant person. So we have a singer, a song lyricist, songwriter with us today. And she's none other than singer Sana Moidatti. She's the very level girl.
Yay! The girl is here!
Hi.
Hi, good evening. How are you?
I'm good, Nancy. How are you?
I'm good too. So how are you dealing with quarantine? Yeah, first of all, a big thank you to you guys, especially because you people who are related to music and arts, you guys are keeping us sane, because without music and arts and entertainment, I think this lockdown would have been very, very, you know, sane. Insane, in fact.
I think it's the same for artists as well. Like, I think that's what I do to keep myself sane. Like, when I get really restless, I just start singing. Or, you know, I take my ukulele and just start playing something, or I listen to music, or I write something. So it's just an extension of what we do. And I'm glad that, you know, it acts as a relief to other people as well, like when we sing or when we do anything. And I'm really happy that I'm able to do this, like, you know, come live, sing a few songs and kind of lighten up the mood.
You know,
for
spreading
everyone,
the, positivity. And yeah, where are you right now? How's the lockdown?
I'm in Mumbai. Okay. So here it's pretty, it's quite, you know, serious over here in Maharashtra.
Okay.
But then
okay.
Because everyone's at home, like we're all hoping that, you know, the cases will come down in, say, like a few weeks or whatever. But yeah.
Provided we follow everything what people say. I mean, the government is saying.
Yeah. I think it's absolutely essential. And I think now people are understanding the seriousness of
the seriousness. Very true.
Of
very
everything.
True.
Of how to handle this whole thing. So yeah, I'm hoping that it should.
So wonderful having you. Welcome. And
thank you. We met before, right, Nancy?
Yes. You came to our studio. It's nice connect with you again. What are you doing at home? How are you keeping yourself occupied? Because now it's like, you know, quarantine has got talent. People are coming up with new talents. People are cooking. And then people are taking fitness challenges. They're doing a lot of things. And it's nice to see such people.
Actually.
What are you up to?
I think this just shows us that everyone is an artist, only that many people don't get the time to kind of explore another side of themselves or whatever. Like, you know, what they get to do new things because there's time now. About me, I've taken up a little bit of production on GarageBand. So, you know, I make a couple of tunes. Another thing is that I'm a night person, so I do everything at night. A big shout out to all my Tamil listeners, actually, because
hello, you have a lot of Tamil people, okay? And they're mad on, and you know what, I want to tell this to you. So I was just quickly going through all the songs, and my favorite is, of course, Karuthappan, okay? And then I just was reading the comments, okay? And then I found one comment, you'll be very happy to hear it. So one guy has commented, a quarantine goal finally found this song. That was something very,
I'm glad
very
it plays in people's minds, and you know, they want to search it.
Imagine this situation. They are searching for your song. So it's something very, it's really cute.
Yeah, I know, it's very
special.
Rewarding, I think, this feeling. You know, when I read certain comments, I feel, okay, this is why I'm doing music. I get that feeling, you know, sometimes when I read certain comments.
I felt, I was like, wow, that's nice. And then the person who created it, you receive that kind of a compliment from people. That's something really, really thoughtful, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
And you started singing by the age of 5 or 6. Very young, no, you were.
Yeah, I started singing when I was 5. So before that, I used to accompany my mom for rehearsals. And she used to sing as well. Okay. So I used to go with her. And then she figured that, you know, I'm interested in music. And she enrolled me in Carnatic classical classes. So that's how it started. The journey started from then. And
your first stage performance. You're still learning. Hello.
really? I'm attending classes. Hindustani, advanced Hindustani vocals. And now the classes happen on video call because I'm not able to go personally and learn.
So which is your favorite genre? Like classical, which is your favorite?
I'm not a very genre specific person. Like, it just has to sound good to me. It can be anything. It can be classical. It can be contemporary Western. It can be just like film light music. It can be jazz. But then I should be able to enjoy the music and I should be able to connect to it. That's my only criteria. I really don't have any favorite.
Tell us about your first stage performance, like so many people in front of you and that butterfly feeling, and then you have to deliver your song properly. Like, how was it?
Actually, I was, as a kid, I was never nervous. In fact, I think I get nervous now. But you know, when
Okay.
you're small, you just have no brains and you do whatever you're being told to do. So, like my mom told me, okay, you know what? You go on stage and perform. I'm like, okay, I'll go on stage and I'll perform. Like that's how it was. It was an instruction. I'll do it, and I enjoyed it. Like the first song I sang on stage was "Chudi Jo Khankegi," and after that I sang "Pia Tu Ab Tu Aa Jaa." And I still remember, like I went dancing onto the stage. But now when I think of it, I think, how did I do that? Like you know,
What did I
probably
just
because I wasn't
do?
thinking much. You don't think much, right, as a kid, so you just do
Yeah,
stuff.
yes.
So that's how it was. Now I'm a little more, I have inhibitions. Yeah. But still, you know, I'm coming back to my childhood days.
And you work a lot of songs with Isaiah Puyal, A.R. Rahman, sir. That's someone's, like, you know, every singer's, every musician's dream to work with him. And
Correct.
you've worked a lot with him. So how is it working with him and, you know?
I think it's one of the best experiences of my life. It was more than a dream to meet him because I think the reason why I took up music was because I heard his music when I was a kid. And it really inspired me to, you know, get into things and understand the working of it and understand, like, you know, how do people make such complex songs and how does it sound so beautiful? That always inspired me. So meeting him was, actually when I met him, I was very blank. I couldn't believe it happened. And he has his aura around him, which can actually make you go
Very
blank, you
true.
know. At least it did that to me. I don't know about others, but it did that
No,
to
very
me.
true, very true. Yeah.
Yeah, because you can feel his presence whenever he enters the room. And but he's a very kind and patient person, and I think he really believes in the artist. And he let me do things, and he made me, you know, push through my comfort zone and experiment. So I'm really thankful for that.
Which is your favorite Tamil song? Like, you know, recently you heard and then you were like,
I have many favorites, in fact. But if not recent, I think again like a Rehman sir song. If I have to, songs like, you know, Malar Gale or Ore Naal. Ore Naal, in fact, I did a cover of it on my channel,
Cover,
Kanmani
yeah,
Anjali.
wonderful, wonderful.
Thank you. Yeah, like last I also sang Rowdy Baby for one of the shows. So I'm just
Oh
learning, you
wow.
know, more Tamil songs to perform.
Tell me one thing, how do you handle with the pronunciations? Because while singing, you have to, you know, concentrate on the tune and then the
Right.
pronunciation, you have to get it correct. How is
Yeah.
it possible? Yeah, so many languages and so many songs and so many genres.
I think it's because I'm a Malayali, so it
Okay.
makes things easier for me because it's already very, Malayalam is such a tough language. So I think if you know, if you can manage a little bit of Malayalam, you can manage a lot of other languages as well. So my biggest challenge would be probably like I had sung a Korean song for one of the shows, like which was a
Wow,
BTS song.
Korean song.
Yeah, and of course I didn't know what it meant. Like I tried to read the translation and stuff, but then still I didn't get the exact meaning. Yet I could figure out the sounds, and I think I'll give the credit to the fact that because I'm a Malayali, I can figure out a lot of difficult sounds, you know. So that's how it works. And generally, any language, there's always a person present to, you know, translate the meaning and the pronunciations for you. So that's how it works. So there's someone who will help you with the phonetics when it comes to any language. So that's how I've managed till now, Tamil, Telugu, these languages basically.
I should have asked you when you sang Kavitha Pane, but then Kavitha Pane, the other, you know, awesome, the, you know, amazing thing is part is where that rap portion comes and then you say, "Wear a level, bro." It's like really, it's a killer, okay? So
Thank
actually,
you.
how did you frame that phrase? Like, how did you think of, you know, getting
Think.
that word into the song? How did you, it happen?
So honestly, I'll tell you how this happened. My band is from Chennai, and
Okay.
they keep saying, "Wear a level, machi, machi, macha, wear a level." For anything, they'll say that. They'll have a cup of tea, they'll be like, "Wear a level." They'll have some food, they'll be
Okay.
like, "Wear a level." And that was very fascinating for me. I'm like, wow, like, you know, this is how these people connect. They say, "Wear a level." And it's fun to catch these phrases from each language where people use it to connect with another person. And while writing the rap, so I wrote that rap, I think, say, in half an hour, 45 minutes, but it just flew.
Okay.
Like, Mona Dinesha, Arealo, she's Wear a Level, bro. I don't know how it came in because it was there in my
Into
subconscious mind,
you.
you know, this phrase, Wear a Level. So I think that's how. And I think that's why people connected to it, because everyone uses it very often, right,
That's
in
the
India.
best part of, it's like when you heard, you know, that part and you're like, "Where level, bro?"
And of course, Mallu is already know Vera Level, but it's I think it's a more Tamil thing to say Vera Level, you know, much
Yeah,
Vera Level.
control also that
So,
very level, bro, that
yeah,
just
Vera
stays.
Level, bro. So that's how the term was coined already, but then I just kind of took it from the archives.
And how did you like get the concept of like, you know, being dark is always stereotyped and, you know, pushed to a side? And why did you think that you had to take up this?
So see, this is actually Karutha Penne. The original song is from the 90s. And
Okay.
though the meaning in the original song and the video, like he calls her, the hero calls the heroine Karutha Penne in a very, very loving manner, like, you know, Karutha
Okay,
Penne
okay.
nene kaanani. But I just thought I'll interpret it in a different way. Karutha Penne means dark woman. So I thought, you know, why not add a social angle to it? That's it. I mean, so that's why I brought in the rap, just to give it a twist over there. And then, of course, because the rap was there, then the entire video kind of, you know, the concept fell in place around that. Because there was a concept involved, so it's just
Wonderful.
an interpretation. Yeah, like of course many people didn't have a problem with that because you know, it's a very nostalgic song and people love the song, but it's in no way to, you know, compete with the original or anything. The original is there, it's legendary, it's made by legends. It's just a tribute to one of the songs that I really love. That's it.
But then how do you manage, you know, you have a lot of recordings, you have to, you know, do a lot of voice training. So how do you take care of your voice and throat?
See, one thing that we need to understand that every singer is different and everyone's vocal capacity is different. So understanding your capacity and how much you can push yourself and where you should be placing your limits, I think that's very important. I have a soft voice. I'm not a person who can scream a lot. Like the day I scream and shout and laugh too much, then by the end of the day my voice is gone. So my Guruji always tells me ki tumhari awaaz aisi hai ki tumhe zyada, you shouldn't talk too much, like you should take it easy. So because of that, like I think for me, like how it works for me is that if I have a recording or if I have a show, I don't talk a lot, and I just keep myself, I'm very silent. And food, I don't place many restrictions. I'm a big foodie. I like to eat
Okay.
everything. But on the day of the show, again, like I avoid eating anything cold or anything which is extremely spicy or oily because you know that leads to acidity, which in turn affects your voice. So that is one.
Okay.
And recently, I stumbled upon this very useful article where they showed how you could, you know, use certain massage techniques to kind of relieve your vocal cords and your jaw and your cheeks and everything, because the entire apparatus is involved when it comes to singing, from here to here, and of course your abdomen and the diaphragm and everything. But this really helps, like, you know, if you can do a little vocal massage externally, like not vocal in the sense these muscles which are involved, if you can do like slight massages for it or whatever. So these small things, I think it helps, like, you
Helps.
know. Another thing is stress. If you have to manage your stress levels when it comes to voice, because the moment I'm stressed, I think it shows in my voice, and that applies to every singer, you know.
But how do you relax yourself? Like, what kind of music you listen to?
Actually, I like to listen to deep house music when I'm stressed. And I go to my terrace and I have a dock. I play music loudly and then there's good breeze and I see the sunset and I listen to deep house music. That music, that's how it works for me, like when I'm stressed. Otherwise, Rehman sir songs, I think that's a very big
Okay.
stress buster for me. I love his music.
So, is there any chance of like, you know, idea of acting, getting into films if you get a chance? Or did you already get and then acting?
See, yeah, I think I'm mainly a musician, not an actor, but there is acting involved while singing. Like there is some kind of voice acting which you do when you
Yeah,
sing
true.
to express yourself. But beyond that, like for a recent video, a cover of the song called Kari Meri Kuruviye Kandila, I acted with a co-actor, and it was so difficult for me in the sense, not because I had to act, but because I had to be comfortable with sharing my space with someone. Like, no, I'm not used to doing that in like as a part of acting. Like if you're friends with someone and if you're hugging someone or if you're holding hands, it's a different thing. But then when you're
Yeah.
acting with a person, you don't know the person, and I'm not a professional actor. So for me to kind of understand, you know, how to not get overwhelmed by this whole process and yet, you know, stay sane and do it and make it look real, I think that was a very big challenge for me. But I enjoyed it. After seeing the outcome, I was like, okay, not bad. Like I can probably pull it off, probably only for my videos. No, but not like some main role and all. I don't think I'll be able to pull it off. But then
If you get
I
an
think for
offer.
videos and all, I really don't know. I haven't thought about it.
So yes, And what are you looking forward to? What is your future goals, and what else you want to do in music, or apart from music? Is there anything else you want to do, a music for a film or something like that?
I'm not thinking anything apart from music now. Like, I think currently I'm really invested in this whole, wanting to release originals and writing my own songs. But I don't write in Hindi, Tamil, Malayalam. I write in English. But I would like to do regional originals as well. So I think my goal is to, come up with singles,
Okay.
independent songs, and collaborate with like various artists and, come up with something beautiful, which, will make me happy and make my audience also happy.
Any plans of doing Tamil songs? Because you have a whole lot of Tamil fans here waiting for you.
Yeah, definitely. In fact, there are a lot of Tamil songs that are going to happen now on my channel.
Okay,
Only that I'm
it's
waiting for this
secret.
lockdown to yeah, I'm just waiting for this lockdown to kind of, relax a bit. Once the situation gets okay, there are so many things that I'm planning to do. And yeah, and Tamil songs are definitely in the list.
Okay, any music director that you are looking forward to work with or collaborate with?
Preetam Da, Bollywood,
Okay.
probably. Yeah, even a lot of independent musicians, in fact, not just music directors, but with YouTube picking up so well, there are so many independent
Yeah,
creators making
no.
such good music. So I definitely like to collaborate with a lot of other artists as well, like not just music composers.
After the
Same.
lockdown is going to get over, what is the first thing that you're going to do?
I think I'll go to Sanjay Gandhi National Park and sit there like for 5 to 10 hours. It's like my favorite place. I just go there and
Okay.
sit. I need to be amidst nature for some time, and that is what I'm going to do first. Like, find a place that's like very green and beautiful, and hopefully it'll start raining by then, so it's going to be nice. Yeah.
Wonderful. So wonderful having you, and you have
Thank you.
so many fans. They're like, wow, awesome, amazing Chichi. And what do you want to
Thanks to
tell
everyone.
to all your fans?
I'd just like to thank everyone, first of all, for all the love that they've been showing me. And apart from that, for now, I just want to tell you all, stay safe, be at home. And this is a time that it's very new to for everyone. It's a very new situation, so we just need to like find the right way to handle it, and we'll all be like successful, and we'll come out safe from this.
Yes,
Yeah,
wonderful
I
having
have to
you.
start in a flow.
Always,
Thank you so much. Hoping to meet
it's
you when I'm in
always,
Chennai.
yeah, please do. And we are expecting more of Tamil and independent music albums of yours.
Yeah,
So all the
sure.
best. Let's,
Thank you, Nancy.
deal with the lockdown and quickly have you very soon in Chennai.
Thank you so much. Radio City.